Australians for Kurdistan have joined with members of the Kurdish community in Melbourne this Saturday for a rally in solidarity with Kurdistan and with the town of Kobani, which for more than a month has been under siege from the forces of ISIS. The rally has been followed down by a march down Swanson Street. As the heroic defence of captured public opinion worldwide, this has partially changed. With much publicity in the past week, there have been airdrops to the YPG and YPJ forces defending the town. However, these have been minimal. Only 28 crates of weapons, one of which had fallen into the hands of ISIS, and the YPG forces are today fighting the 41st day of their resistance.
My name is Turan Ertekin, and we will here to support Kobani the fight against the ISIS. We support the Kobani. This morning for the rally organized by the lot of the Australian Democrat, Socialists, and Union leadership and community organization all together joined the rally. We show the support to the Kobani, and our demand is, first of all, Australian government should be support the military eye in the Kobani. The secondly, we will defend, the demand is the YPG and PKK should be out of the list for the terrorist organization, because they fight in their land, they fight for freedom. That's why we can support and partner with them. And we will continue to this until we get to the Kobani freedom for Kobani. We will demand Russia international community and international other organization put the pressure to the Turkish government, open the corridor for the aid for economic aid, medicine aid, for other all, etc. That's all.
Free, free Kurdistan!
Kurds and be in solidarity with the Kurds in Kobani, what's happening in Kobani. As you are aware, the Kurdish people in Kobani are going through some tough times. There are no international support given to the people of Kobani. Me being from a Kurdish background, as you can see, I feel there's no support. You know, they say that there are international support, but there's only minimal support going to the Kurds at the moment. And we need to increase awareness amongst the international community so they could see exactly what's going on and what's happening with the Kurds. And it seems like people are keeping silent and not doing anything about it.
Well, firstly, I think the Kurds need to be supported by everybody. Anybody who supports socialism, human rights, social justice struggle should be supporting the Kurds. I think that's really important for two reasons. Firstly, it's a humanitarian issue to stop any potential massacre of the Kurdish people and the people living in Kobani. But secondly, it's important to defend this new democratic society, self-governing society that the Kurds are creating in Rojava. They're creating a society which involves all people who live there, not only Kurds, it's Kurdish majority, but all minority religions, minority ethnic groups, but also the liberation of women. Women play a huge role in that area because it's got left-wing leadership. And also they're trying, it's an anti- capitalist struggle. They're building an anti-capitalist society of self-management, of workers' cooperatives, communal farming of land. But that's all been interrupted because ISIS opposes that, the US opposes that, the Turkish government opposes that, Assad, the Syrian government.